Okay, so now if we're going to find our derivatives with negative indices or even fractional indices, I might do one or two fraction ones. It's exactly the same process, but we just got to get used to working with negative numbers, adding and subtracting one from negative numbers, or adding and subtracting one from fractions. So to find the derivative, dy dx is equal to, the power is 1, 1 times 4 is 4, minus, we'll get rub out that there. So the power is negative 3 multiplied by negative 3. So it's negative 3 times x minus 3 minus 1. 4, negative and negative is positive 3x. Negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4. Yeah. So it is possible we might write that as 4 plus 3 over x to the 4. Right, so that's what my derivative rule, my gradient rule is in that instance. What about in the next one? Same thing. Dy dx is equal to negative 2 comes out the front, so it becomes negative 4x. Minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. Negative 1 comes out the front. Negative 1 times negative 6 is positive 6. X minus 1 is minus 2. So more than happy with that, but don't forget we could possibly write it as putting it as a positive index, and so we put them into the denominator. If I just create another one there and just put y equals x to the half plus 4x to the minus a half. Same thing. Dy dx is equal to a half comes out the front, x, a half minus 1 is minus a half, plus negative a half times 4 is negative 2x, minus a half minus 1, minus a half minus 1 is equal to minus a half minus 2 on 2, which equals negative 3 on 2. Yeah? So possibly I might write it as 1 over 2x to the half plus negative 2 over x to the 3 on 2. Don't forget x to the half could be written as the square root of x minus 2 over, and I might have the square root of x, oops, square root of x cubed. All right. So whether they're negative numbers or fractional numbers, it's exactly the same process. One last little one there. B, find the gradient of the tangent at the point where f of x equals. So find the gradient. F of x equals x squared minus, I'm going to rewrite it. 1 on x is the same as x to the minus 1. So f dashed of x is equal to 2 at the front, take 1 from the power. Minus 1 times a minus is plus x. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. So that's my derivative. 2x plus 1 on x squared. Now find the gradient at the point 1, 2. So the tangent line is really the point on the curve. So a tangent line down here at the bottom of the screen is a point where it touches the curve. And that tangent line has the same gradient. So it's just another way of saying what's the gradient at that point. So at x equal to 1, f dashed of x is equal to 2 times 1 plus 1 over 1 squared, which is 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. So therefore, gradient is 3 at x equal to 1. All right, so I want you to do these and then I'll be working on the sheet that I give you. Okay, so let's look at, consider what the graph of a gradient function. Okay, so that's what we're concentrating on, the gradient of the line, which is also the derivative function. So let's consider this, well, these two key points here. Okay, we know from when we first sketched our cubic graphs, all right, they're my turning points. And if I draw a line that touches those graphs there, that's where my gradient is zero. Okay, so if you like, since we're talking about g of x, g dashed of x is equal to 0 at those points. What about to the right of a? So that section there, what sort of a sloping line is that? Okay, that's got a positive gradient, isn't it? So concentrate on the x value, so it's a domain for a greater than, for x greater than a, the gradient or the derivative is greater than 0. Yeah, and obviously then at x equal to a, the gradient is 0. What about in between? Let's go with the black line in through here. Basically a negative sloping graph, isn't it? It starts at 0, then it gets a little bit negative, gets steeper, back to 0. So that section there, between what value? So between b and a, notice they're strictly less than. We have the derivative or the gradient is less than 0. And then if I come back out to this section here, in green again, we've got a positive sloping graph. So again, if x is less than b, the gradient is less than 0. So it's concentrating on the gradient of the line, not the y value. Obviously in here at b, we're equal to 0 again. So x equal to b, g dashed of b is equal to 0. All right, so we're concentrating on the slope of the line, not the position where we are. I know, for example, from that point there, the graph and down, the graph is negative, but that's the graph is negative. The y value is negative. I'm concentrating on the gradient of the line, okay? So that's really important. So let's have a look at this one here. Whereabouts is f dashed of x strictly greater than 0? So whereabouts is the gradient of the line positive? So where is the gradient of the line positive? So that's gradient is 0 there, and it's all positive gradients all the way between there and there, yeah, but not at the end point. So the x values are negative 1. So between negative 1 and 5, I've got a positive gradient. So that's the same as saying m is greater than 0, okay? Whereabouts is the gradient negative? Well, that's a negative slope there. Negative slope there. So we're going to say if the numbers are less than negative 1 or if the numbers are greater than 5, the gradient f dashed of x is negative. Where is it equal to 0? Well, at those turning points. So at x equal to negative 1 and 5, the gradient f dashed of x is equal to 0. All right, so you've got to concentrate on the slope. Now, if I have to sketch the gradient graph, sometimes we can't, all we can do is an approximate. Okay, so all we can do here is, well, let's concentrate on the two halves of the graph, shall we? We've got a positive gradient there in black, a zero gradient there at 3. So at 3, so I'm going to put that as f dashed of x, and that's x, and at x equal to 3, the gradient is 0. Greater than 3, okay, the gradient is positive. Now, I know it's a straight line because this graph is sort of basically an x squared graph, which means the derivative is basically a 2x graph. Might be a little bit different, 2x plus something or 6x or, you know, it might have a different slope, but it's a straight line. So what if equal to 0, nice red dot. Now, this section of the graph has a negative slope. Not too sure exactly how big a slope. And so I'm going to draw it that way. Now, I don't know. Those points there are not the same. The y-intercept there at x equal to 0 is not the same value there. Because here the y value is positive, but here the gradient is negative. okay? So they're different values, the intercepts, all right? The only thing I do know is that where my gradient, the graph has a zero gradient, that's on the intercept of the f dashed of x graph. Let's try number two. What do we know about that? So again, we've got the gradient graph and x. Well, that's the line of y equals what? That's a rise over run, isn't it? So that's the y equals x plus 1. So I know the gradient of this graph. It's 1 everywhere. So the gradient of this graph, okay, is 1 everywhere, all right, because that's what the gradient of that line is. For number C, again, we've got a couple of points where we have a zero gradient, so I might put those in red. Zero gradient there, zero gradient there. So what's that? Negative 1.5, so I'll put it there. And a positive 1, so I might just make it a bit shorter. So 1, negative 1.5, the gradient is 0. What f dashed of x and x, all right? So what's happening in between? So let's go with our blue. So what sort of a line is that? Okay, we've got a positive sloping line, haven't we? So if x is less than negative 1.5, the line has a positive slope. So it's above. Okay, don't forget that this section up here, f dash is greater than 0. That's everything above the axis. Okay, what about where x is greater than 1? The slope is also positive here, isn't it? So I've got a positive slope if x is greater than 1. So something like that. Is it perfectly straight? Is it a bit curved? Well, in reality, because we think it looks like a bit of a cubic graph, it's possibly a bit curved, but it's not that important, to be honest. It's just, are we above or below the line? What about in between? In between negative 1.5, that's all negative slope, isn't it? So what happens? My graph goes down, and then at some point in time, it starts to get shallow again. Now, I don't know where that point is, all right? I don't know how far down it goes. All I know is it's a negative slope in through here. So negative slope in through here because we're below the line. Everything down here is a negative slope, all right? It gets as steep as it's going to get, maybe around there. All right, so you could argue that maybe that point there is somewhere near negative 1, maybe. Okay, it's hard to tell. And then it turns around and comes back up towards a zero gradient again. All right, so that's roughly what our graph looks like. So it's focusing on the slope of the line, and the only points we know definitely are the turning points, okay? So I know where those points are specifically because that's where the gradient is zero. So they match off on my actual graph to those. All right. The last thing I guess we should think we need to consider is that the angle, we've spoken about already how if I have, no, it doesn't matter, if I have a curve, and we draw what we call a tangent line, okay? And the tangent line is a point where it touches. And the thing about a tangent line is a tangent line and the curve both have the same gradient. So the gradient of tangent is same as gradient of the curve, all right? So they've got the same gradient. So what's the gradient of this line? Well, the gradient is rise over run, isn't it? So it's rise over run. And if that was an angle, it would be the same as opposite over adjacent, which is tan theta. So what that really means for us is that the gradient of a line is given by tan of the angle of that line. Okay, so a line, but it makes an angle of 45 degrees, 10 or 45 is 1, so that tells you the gradient of the line. So, oh, excuse me, sorry, gents. Find the coordinates of the points on the curve y equals x squared at which the tangent makes an angle of 45 degrees. So, what does that mean? So, another way of interpreting, the tangent line makes an angle, therefore, that means that tan of 45 degrees is equal to the tangent. All right, that's what that statement means. So whereabouts is that? So what is tan of 45? So tan of 45 is 1. So in other words, the question is saying, where is the derivative equal to 1? That's the challenge in this particular topic. So that whole statement there, that really means, where is dy dx equal to 1? All right, that's what that line means. So now, once we decide that, well, dy dx is equal to 2x minus 7. So solve 2x minus 7 equal to 1. I get 2x is equal to 8, x is equal to 4. So at x equal to 4, the gradient is 1. Find the coordinates. So at x equal to 4, so what's the y value? Y will be equal to 4 squared minus 7 times 4 plus 8, 16 minus 28 plus 8, which equals negative 4. So at the point 4, negative 4, gradient m is equal to 1. All right? Find where the line is parallel to the line y equals negative 2x minus 6. So, if lines are parallel, what do we know about their gradients? They're the same, aren't they? If I was to give this a quick sketch, does that factorise nice? Minus 8 plus 1, so we have to complete the square on it. Minus 7 on 2, sorry, 3 on 2. And at 3 on 2, I get 9 on 4. I get a negative value. Y-intercept at 8. Looks something like that. So that's the point 3 on 2 something. Okay, that's 8. So let's have a look at the first answer. The first answer says, whereabouts is the gradient 1? It says at 4, negative 4. So the point 4, negative 4 must be about there. Does that look like it's got a gradient of 1? Yeah, probably. So that's reasonable. And the other one says, whereabouts is the line parallel to y equals negative 2x plus 6? So y equals negative 2x plus 6 might look something like that. So whereabouts are these lines parallel? So maybe it's, I don't know, somewhere like that. We've got the same gradient. So in other words, what B talks about, so what does it mean? It means where is dy dx equal to negative 2? Because if the lines are parallel, it means they have the same gradient. So let's solve dy dx, which we worked out. It's 2x minus 7. So I get 2x is equal to 5. X is equal to 5 on 2. So again, I need a coordinate. So I can put y equal to 5 on 2 squared. On 2 squared minus 7 times 5 on 2 plus 8, which is equal to 25 on 4. Minus 35 on 2 plus, I'm going to write that at 8 fours of 32 on 4, which is equal to 25 minus 70 plus 32 all over 4, which is 57 minus 70, which is 13, isn't it? Negative 13 on 4. So the point that we're interested in is 5 on 2, negative 13 on 4. Let's see if that's reasonable. Well, that's a problem. That's 5 on 2 there. So what's that value there? Let's check. That value there should be 7 on 2, shouldn't it? So that's actually 7 on 2, the turning point. Sorry about that. Which means 5 on 2 is there somewhere, which seems reasonable. It seems like it would have a negative gradient, possibly of negative 2. All right? So again, it's interpreting what the question wants from you. And in this case, it wanted to know where the gradient was negative 2, which means where is the derivative negative 2. All right? Off you go.